our project's focuses not exactly on seals, but on early medieval and early modern coats of arms. Nevertheless, the seals and the information associated with them are crucial for our project. Our project is called Code of Arms in Practice, and it deals with codes of arms as means of communication and thus as sources of cultural history. The first phase of the project focused on the way codes of arms functioned as means of communication and how they gained the success they had as such in the late Middle Ages and early modern times. The second phase now of our project is concerned with the concrete development of codes of arms as a means of communication. Here we are interested in how they have become more complex over time and how the range of possibilities for their use and form has become more and more differentiated. For this purpose, we are developing an infrastructure that integrates heraldic data from multiple historic sources while also keeping the historic context of these sources. Now, seals are, of course, aside from memorials, the most important type of source for us because they can provide us with such context. Firstly, seals with coats of arms on it let us attribute a given coat of arms to a person or an institution. If we still have the document or the documents the seal was attached to, we are able to fix a date or at least a fuzzy time period in which a certain coat of arms, which was on the seal, was used by its bearer. Furthermore, if we have multiple seals of the same person or family or institution, we can track the development and changes of the coats of arms used by its person or the institution over time. And finally, if we use large data sets, it becomes easier to study marginalized groups in this context. The use of heraldry was widely common in the Middle Ages and early modern times. And to name just an example, Jews could also bear coats of arms, but they presented them nearly exclusively on seals. So this type of historical source, the seals with coats of arms, can offer us a direct insight into much larger pre-modern contexts and use of heraldry. And going beyond that, coats of arms were, of course, not only used on seals, but in a huge variety of other contexts. They appeared in manuscripts or wall paintings or on glass paintings, just to name a few examples. So we have multiple instances of the same coat of arms, some being contextualized, but monochrome, like on seals, and some having nearly no context at all, but being fully colored, like in memorials. So we have multiple information we are interested in. The image of the seal with a coat of arms, its provenance, so which document it was attached to, for example, and the context of its provenance. For example, when was it used, or by whom was it used, or in whatever context was it used. And the goal of our project now is to build an infrastructure that covers all of these different aspects. And by using semantic web technologies and machine learning, we aim to detect, link, and integrate heraldic data from these multiple sources. Seals pose an important part of such an infrastructure, as I just illustrated. And all this will allow us to study them with qualitative as well as quantitative methods on a very large scale based on precise data of their temporal and historical context. And the first aspect I mentioned here poses, of course, the first challenge for us. How do we find images of seals with coats of arms on them? And especially, how do we process a large amount of them? And as you know, and as we have seen in the past minutes, there already exist a number of interesting projects where image data of seals is made publicly available. Some of them even provide additional information if a coat of arms is depicted on a seal. In the database Sigilla, in this example, I can search for armorial to get seals that only have coats of arms on them. And in some cases, the description of the database includes the blason, so meaning the description of the coat of arms itself. And this is, of course, very important. But since we want to base our research on large amounts of data, we must be able to also include unlisted seals. In other words, we must be able to process image data automatically and detect which of them do include coat of arms. And to achieve this, we use image detection methods based on machine learning. Earlier this year, we already trained a model to detect coat of arms in medieval manuscripts with promising results. And in the meantime, we have also trained a model on the architecture YOLO version 4, the image detection machine learning architecture. And we trained a model with this to specifically detect coat of arms in seals. And to create a training set for this, we automatically scraped a test dump from the Sigillar database with a Python script. And with this, we tested our image detection model for the manuscripts on the images of the seals. And this was unsuccessful at first, but showed better results after we retrained the model again. And for this, we just had to annotate a few hundred images of seals from the dump we scraped, which had coats of arms on them. And the results were much better this time. You can see two examples here. We have now achieved a precision of 86% and a recall of 83%, meaning about 86% of the predictions made automatically by the detector were correct, while it found 83% of the coats of arms that were overall present in the evaluation set. So about 20% of the coats of arms in our set were ignored by the image detector. Of course, there are still a few challenges in this case ahead of us. Aside from increasing precision and recall, there can often be difficulties with coats of arms that look slightly different from the rest of the training set. For example, when the coat of arms is tilted in the image, like you can see, like you can see in this example. Here, this worked quite well. Both coats of arms are tilted, but they were detected by the image detector. In the example of the manuscript, it doesn't work so much. I don't know if you can see it, but here is a tilted coat of arms, and this has no border around it, so it was ignored by the detector. To enhance these results, we need to test, for example, different approaches of data augmentation, meaning we will artificially increase and diversify our training set without getting new images. And YOLO does incorporate already some of these strategies of data augmentation to improve the results, but they're still open ground to improve this. Nevertheless, these are results we can already work with. We are now able to process large amounts of image data and infer exactly where on these images coats of arms can be found and address them individually. And the results you can see here on the slide are only a representation of the results created by YOLO. More important than these images is the possibility to further process the detected coat of arms automatically. So our next step is to make the acquired coat of arms machine readable. Only then can we make individual occurrences of coat of arms comparable to other ones and identify which coat of arms were used on which other seals and in which other contexts, aside from seals like manuscript or wall paintings. And machine readability, of course, offers us to do this in a scalable way with very large amounts of data. And to achieve this, we are currently developing a formalized ontology, which is based on the description of coat of arms by Blason. So here, the classes and relations of the ontology incorporate the different heraldic terms and layers of a coat of arms. And with this, we hope to propose a formalized and standardized way to describe a coat of arms in general. And we are planning to release a first version of this ontology at the beginning of the second quarter of next year, of 2021. At this moment, the classification of heraldic imagery. So we automatically got our image of a coat of arms, but the classification of the coat of arms on. Genau. The classification of this coat of arms has to be done manually at this point in the project. But in the long run, this should be done at least semi-automatically as well. And for this component here of our infrastructure, we are developing an image classifier again with machine learning methods in collaboration with computer scientists from the University of Münster. So at this point, we can detect and localize individual coat of arms on seals and on manuscripts. And by keeping the data provenance context of each image and encoding it in this part of the of the ontology here, we can acquire the coat of arms from different databases along with information on their historical context. And this context has then to be semantically enriched further in an additional step. This can be done, for example, by including the individual persons, families, institutions, and dominions, while enriching them further with semantic and spatial information where it is possible. So, where, for example, when had a person, when did a person live, or what was its dominion if it was a noble person, something like that. And this will, of course, be the decisive element to enable historic analysis, because only here we can find the actors that actually use the coat of arms, thereby linking the historical sources over time and space. And as you can see, our proposed approach shall be able to process the data as automatically as possible to achieve a high throughput of data. This does also concern these entry points of data for there where we get data from other projects and repositories. We want, of course, to incorporate heraldic evidence from a wide variety of historical contexts. Nevertheless, stereographic databases account for an important part of this. And therefore, we are looking to integrate more data on seals. Though for that, we need a few things. Firstly, we need more image data to train and enhance our detection models. Enhance our training, we can find more coats of arms and classify them better. But we also need more metadata about the images that describe the context of the images, but in a formalized way. And ideally, these metadata are also presented in a standardized form. This makes it much easier to process data from various different sources or various different databases. An example for this that we already worked with this year is the IIIF presentation API. That is used by some libraries to describe the scans of the pages of a medieval manuscript. And so you have one way all sources are described. So it's interoperable. In other words, we would profit very greatly from a formalized standard to describe seals. And finally, and ideally, getting the data should be automatically possible as well. Somehow we can, of course, achieve this at this moment through web scraping, but this means programming new software to download data from each new data repository or database, and it means making it necessary to harmonize a variety of metadata models into our own. And aside from the perspectives on historiographic insight, this linkage of the same coat of arms over multiple data pools that we suggest will also help with the identification on seals. So let's say we have a seal that is very badly damaged. We are able to detect that there is a coat of arms, but we are not capable of classifying it completely. Maybe it is not possible neither to decipher all of its heraldic charges, nor can we decipher its the transcription of the seal. And of course, the classification of heraldic imagery will always be easier in a colored manuscript than on a monochrome seal, regardless of an automatic or manual identification. But by combining a formalized description of coat of arms with their linkage of multiple occurrences, we will be able to account for incomplete image data. Since we have a graph database with a multitude of combinations of charges, fields, and tinctures from other coats of arms taken from other manuscripts or other seals, we could be able to at least present a probability which coat of arms we are dealing with in this case. So the overall goal of for us is then to make all these results accessible as linked open data. And thereby, we hope to create a knowledge system that is reusable by you or by other communities that are dealing in some way with heraldic data. And this knowledge system should be able to put heraldic imagery into its historic context by taking the high diversity and heterogeneity of contexts of their use into account. It a knowledge system that this that offers vice versa a possibility to analyze the aforementioned historic context, but with respect to coats of arms, and this going beyond single data silos or a single image database. And that is providing a formalized and standardized way to describe coats of arms as a historical source, the ontology I mentioned before. And finally, thus place seals based on their coats of arms in a larger context of heraldic and visual communication. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.